And I think this is a great question. And it's funny how we probably will never ask this very same question regarding financial performance. And that's because the traditional financial sector has already developed standard definitions to measure financial performance. However, when we look for the impact investing industry, despite all the progress we have made in the recent years, there is still some work to do. One of the main distinguished features of impact investing is, of course, the impact. But if we as investors would like to claim that we are creating any impact, we have to be able to measure it, and most importantly, in a credible way. So in a nutshell, I see impact performance as the foundation to attract more private investments to the sector. Looking at an organizational level, here at the CFC, we also see measuring our impact performance as an essential thing for our operation, because this would allow us to understand how the companies we support are creating impact. It also would help us to invest more effectively, creating more practical impact. Also, it's useful for us to compare how we are performing when we see the rest of the industry. And finally, we find this also useful for the companies we support, because it can be a valuable tool for them to understand better their business and create even more impact. Just providing a quick background on the CFC, the fund was created about 30 years ago under the framework of the United Nations to support commodity producers in developing countries. Today, we operate as an impact investor, mainly by providing loans to SMEs working on the agricultural value chains. We decided to adopt the SDGs as our main framework to manage impact, and we selected 5 goals more aligned with our mission to be our core SDGs. Although the SDGs are a great framework to report on impact, we realized that can be challenging for the private sector to use them. So to solve this issue, we decided to adopt the IRIS metrics as our reporting tool. So what we did was to map the IRIS metrics with the SDGs and ask all the companies to report using these metrics. This process actually starts when the organization submits an application to receive finance from the CFC. And at this moment, they have already to inform the impact they expect to create for each year of operation. So during the assessment of the company, which includes an on-site visit and, of course, the social and environmental due diligence, we sit together with the company and try to select the most appropriate indicators for the organization. And we try to understand their context, their constraints for reporting the indicators, keeping in mind the minimum requirements from the CFC. The final list of indicators, it's included on the loan agreement signed with the company. So this is how we do it, for example, with Olivado, a company that we have recently supported, and it's included on the impact study from the gym. And this is an avocado oil producer in Kenya, who is reaching more than 2,000 smallholder farmers. And for us, it was important to understand how the farmers were benefiting for working with the Olivado. So some indicators for us that was extremely important to have was the pricing premium that Olivado pays to the smallholders when compared to the local market's prices, and what is the additional income the farmers earn from working with the Olivado. So that's usually how we manage our impact. Given what we have discussed so far, I have to say, properly monitor your impact. As you know, the sector has been growing at an impressive rate on the past few years. And with the emergency of new crises like the COVID-19, the climate change, the immigration issue, more and more people are asking or demanding even that their investments result in more than just creating finance return. They would like to give also a contribution to alleviate these big issues we are facing. So there is a space for new investors to enter in the industry. And if you look for the segment where the CFC focus on, for example, which is the agricultural sector, this is the biggest employer in the world. More than 500 million smallholders farmers go to cultivate their lands every day. The opportunities for growth and for achieving great impact are impressive. But we need more investors and organizations looking at these opportunities, having new ideas, supporting the local business, which will for sure result in more impact for the society and for the planet.